Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over the second example on how to find the domain of rational functions algebraically. Okay, so let's take a look at the directions for the example. We are to find the domain of the following rational function. So for number two, we have the rational function f of x equals 2x times x minus 3 divided by x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. Okay, so as indicated in problem number 1, if you want to find the domain of a rational function of this nature, all you have to do is find the value of x, value or values of x that causes the entire expression to be undefined. So what causes an expression to be undefined? Any value that causes the denominator to have a value of 0 results in the entire expression becoming undefined. Okay, so our focus will be, or should be, on the denominator. So when you're looking for the domain of a rational function, all you just have to do is solve for when the denominator is equal to 0. And you are going to exclude those answers from your domain, okay? If those values are excluded from your domain, you're guaranteed to have a defined output for all your inputs. All right, so taking a look at this example, what is the denominator? The denominator is the product of these two quantities, x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. Okay, so we'll set it equal to 0, and then we'll solve this quadratic equation. When we solve this factored quadratic equation, our answers should be excluded from the domain, and we will have the domain of this function. All right? So how do we solve a quadratic equation in factored form? To solve this, we will apply the zero product property. Okay? It just basically says that if the product of two numbers are 0, then one of the numbers has to be 0. Okay? So either x plus 3 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. All right? So we're going to have two values to be excluded from the domain of this function right here. Let's solve the first one. Subtract 3 from both sides. We'll have x equals negative 3. And then if you take a look at the second equation, all you do is you add 3 to both sides and divide by 2. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this. Add 3 to both sides. That yields 2x equals positive 3. And then divide both sides by 2. That will isolate x for us. And then we'll have x equals 3 over 2. All right? So the question is, what do these two values mean? What does this mean? Well, these two values, when you plug them into this function, you will have an undefined output. So that means those numbers have to be excluded from the domain. All right, so how do we write our final answer? Let's go ahead and write it down. The domain is the set of x's such that x cannot be negative 3 and x cannot be 3 over 2. Okay, and any other value we yield a defined output for this function. So the domain restricts X is to everything apart from these values right here. So X cannot be, the slash there, X cannot be negative 3, and X cannot be 3 over 2. So that's the domain of our function, all right? So that's that. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. If you have any questions or would like to request tutorials for us to make for you, feel free to include it in the comments section below this video. More clips can be found on mathgodserve.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.